Good afternoon and welcome. On behalf of the Wheeler family and the Barham family, I'd like to extend our gratitude and thanks for having so many of you here with us this day. Jennifer Lorraine Wheeler Bryant, 29. Passed away unexpectedly Wednesday, August the 17th. She was preceded in death by her grandparents, Francis Cash and Bill Barham, and her great-grandparents, Evelyn and Otha C. Wheeler. Jennifer is survived by her parents, Scott and Julia Wheeler, sisters Amanda Wheeler and Candace Roser, her brother Damian Wheeler, children Aldrin Rodriguez Wheeler, Nikolai Fralin, and Skyanne Fralin, her grandparents Becky Wheeler, Otha Wheeler, and Don Cash, her niece Evelyn Wheeler, as well as a numerous aunts, uncles, great aunts, great uncles, and cousins. Let us pray. Most gracious and kind Heavenly Father, we humbly come before your throne of mercy and grace. Father, seeking comfort for our hearts that long for our loved one. As we mourn the loss of Jennifer, we pray not for her, for in our hearts we believe she's with you. But dear God, please continue to us your presence and your protection. Please continue to comfort us in our hour of need. Father God, I beg upon you to be with us during this service. Give us the strength. Give us the comfort that can only come from you. Father, we pray this prayer. We ask of these things now in the holiest name of Jesus Christ. And all of God's people said, Amen.
Why did she have to go? So young, I just don't know why things happen half the time, without reason, without rhyme. Lovely, sweet young woman, daughter, wife, and mother, makes no sense to me. I just have to believe she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and paths where no one sees, and she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting, and I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. Loved ones she left behind, just trying to survive and understand the why. Feeling so lost inside, anger shot straight at God, then asking for his love, empty with disbelief, just hoping that maybe she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and paths where no one sees, and she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting, and I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. It's hard to say goodbye, her picture in my mind will always be of times I'll cherish, and I won't cry, 'cause she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and paths where no one sees, and she walks with Jesus, and her loved ones waiting. And I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. Don't worry about me. Don't worry about me.
I believe if Jennifer could talk with us right now, that would be her message. Don't worry about me. If anyone would like to share a memory or a thought, we'd love to hear it. Do remind you that we're being recorded, and so in order to make it a part of the recording, we have to give you a microphone. So, but if you would like to share a memory, we'd certainly love to have you do it at this time.
Mostly when she was a teenager. But for some time, we hung out just about every day. I had a lot of fun and laughs with her. I'll always remember her.
Thank you very much. Many of you here know me. Jenny was my niece. Scripture teaches us in Romans, in the 8th chapter, the Apostle Paul writes, "Can anything ever separate us from Christ's love? Does it mean he no longer loves us if we have trouble or calamity or persecuted or hungry or destitute or in danger or threatened with death? No. Despite all these things, overwhelming victory and desires through Christ who loved us." Paul continues to say, "I am convinced that nothing can separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today nor our worries about tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below, indeed nothing at all in creation, will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. As children of God, we now have a future home, a house not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens. Much has been written about heaven, more than we could ever cover today. But for just a moment, I'd like for us to look at some of the emotions and the reactions of heaven. I believe the sentiments of those that are already in heaven are best expressed to us by King David in his writings in the 16th Psalm, where he says to God, he said, "You, God, will show me the path of life. In your presence is the fullness of joy, and at your right hand are pleasures forevermore." The Apostle Paul tells about a man who went up and was taken up into the heavens, and he heard inexpressible things, things that no one was permitted to tell. Now, we aren't given the specifics of what either of these men experienced. But one thing is very clear, and then is this, that in the presence of God, we will experience pure joy and wonder. Today, as we remember Jennifer, it is worth noting that she trusted in Jesus Christ as her Lord and Savior. And she's now made that transition from this world to the next. She has exchanged her citizenship from that of this earth to the kingdom of God. She can now experience what many of us have looked forward to for a long time. That of being in the very presence of God in His glory. Just as it is said in that old hymn, where by His grace I shall look upon His face. That will be glory, that will be glory for me. Thoughts of heaven and an eternity in the service of God are wonderful to think about and talk about. But Jennifer has passed from this life in faith and is now experiencing with new eyes what her heart had told her was true for many years. God's words say that those who make a decision to trust in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior can fully understand what the Apostle Paul meant when he said, For I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that He, God, is able to keep what I have committed to Him until the day. We meet here today to honor and pay tribute to the life of Jennifer Lorraine and to express our love for her. Jennifer, sister, cousin, daughter, mother, friend to many and many other. We're here to give thanks to God for her life of 29 years and to commit her back to God's merciful and tender hands. We have come together from different places, and each of us are at a different stage on our journey through life. Our paths are varied, and we look at life in different ways. But there is one thing that we all have in common, and that is at one point or another, and to some degree or other, our lives have been touched by Jennifer's life. And so today, as we have put aside our usual daily activities for just a while, and we have gathered here to give expression to the thoughts and feelings that well up in us at a time like this, at a time of loss, and also because in one way or another, Jennifer's life and death has affected us all. The late Helen Keller on one occasion said, "What we have once enjoyed and deeply loved, we can never lose. For all that we love deeply becomes a part of us." Let us seek comfort and find strength from God's holy word. The prophet Isaiah writes, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God, and I will strengthen you, and I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." How comforting it is to know that we can go to God in our hour of need and know that He will lift us up. But you see, today is not just an ordinary day for any of us. No, today marks one of those special times and seasons of life. You know, most of us do not come to funerals very often, and we do not have to wrestle with the reality of death frequently. But there are several special aspects about us being gathered here today. You see, today is a significant time for several reasons. Today marks a time of rejoicing. Again, listen to the Apostle Paul's words. When he said, "We are confident, yes, well pleased rather, to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord." For us, it is a day of sorrow and grief, but for Jennifer, today marks a time of rejoicing. She is truly experiencing a much higher quality of life. The book of Revelation gives us the truth that there is no more sickness, pain, sorrow, or tears. You see, for Jennifer, today is commencement exercise day. She has graduated to a better life. She has graduated into glory. Today marks a time of remembering. Beautiful flowers, lovely music, and our very presence here today are all in honor of the life that Jennifer lived. Today is a day for remembering her. We're blessed and fortunate in that are so and that are so many good memories. Today also marks a time of grieving. You see, losing someone we love produces genuine pain and grief. And while we have tears of joy, we also have tears of sadness. Those who have walked this road know that grieving is a common process that takes several forms, and it progresses through several stages. But the key to successfully moving through these stages is choosing to take each one of them to God. So as you're here today to comfort one another and to be comforted ourselves, let us remember that grief never ends, but it changes. You see, grief is a passage, and in many ways it is a journey, but it's not a place to stay. Grief is not a sign of weakness, nor is it a lack of faith. No, grief is the price. It is the price that we pay for love. And today is also a time of examination. Scripture instructs us to examine yourselves as to whether you are in the faith. Test yourselves. Do you not know yourselves that Christ Jesus is in you? Funerals are reminders to us of the certainty and the reality of death and the inevitability of examination. We all should prepare ourselves for death because, you see, Scripture tells us after this, the judgment. As Christians, we have the assurance because we know the truth in the words of that old song, that old hymn that says, "My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. And I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name." But even with this truth, Jesus knew that worry and uncertainty would creep into our lives and as a liar and a deceiver. But to remind us of all this, Jesus told his disciples in John 14, he said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms, and if it were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare you a place? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am." I know that we will all sincerely miss Jennifer. But I can promise you that the very worst thing that can happen between two children of God is just temporary separation. One day, all of us who have asked Jesus Christ to save us from our sins, we will see our fellow Christians again. To them, it will seem as if it's just a little time has passed. And if they could speak to us now, they would say, "Please don't cry for me. Cry if you need to, but only because of the temporary separation, because we can all be together again." So whether that happens or not is related to the biggest question of life. And that question is this: who is Jesus Christ? Who is he to you? Is he a great man? Is he God's son? Or is he just the founder of a great world religion? Or is he your Savior, your Lord, and your friend? Because if you really do know him, then one day when you stand before him, he will acknowledge that he knows you. And he will welcome you into eternity. Just as he did with Jennifer a few days ago. So as we remember Jennifer today, remember that each human soul lives forever. Physical death is merely the point of transition between a few years here on earth and in eternity with or without God. If you knew anything about Jennifer, you knew she was a very colorful and fun-loving person. So listen to the song.
Lately I've been reflecting, stuck at this intersection. Can't figure which way to go to get myself out this depression. Wondering if it's worth it, wondering while I'm searching. Wondering if I'll find out that nothing is ever perfect. I wonder if God can hear me, never felt more deserted. Feel like I'll never flourish, I've never felt more discouraged. Gotta be more to life than just living and dying. A cloud of smoke behind me now because the bridge is on fire. I used to think it was cool to hustle, but now I know that I can't buy my way to heaven with the drugs I sold. Lord, won't you guide the way for me, cause I got both eyes closed. And if Moses can part the sea, then help me just let go.
Paul writes in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. He said, "But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring him with those who sleep in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout and with the voice of an archangel and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first, and then we who are alive and remain shall be called up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words." Let us pray. Most gracious Heavenly Father, again we come before you to thank you for being with us today. And just ask that you would continue to the family and to those of us who are hurting, continue to us your spirit of comfort. Father God, there's so many mysteries concerning death and eternity And Father, I just pray that you would give us the wisdom, the knowledge, and the insight that we need. As we go through these days, struggling with the question of why, help us to know, Father, that your will is a perfect will. Help us to accept that, Father. Dear God, be with us now as we depart from here. I beg upon you that you would watch over us and protect us, lead us and guide us. This we pray, this we ask all in the holy name of Christ. Amen. I'd like to announce on behalf of the family that if any would like to gather at the home down in Rocky Mount, there'll be food and some time for fellowship and laughing and gathering. If you don't know the address, we can text it to you, or you can follow Julia, or just any number of ways. But please, if you'd feel free to come and join in with that. And I'd like to thank you again on behalf of the family for being here with us today. And this concludes the service.